Norm Karkos has been following this story for the past several hours. He is in Watertown right now. So, Norm, what is the latest? What can you tell us at this time?
Well, good evening, Megan. We are anticipating a 5:30 press conference here in Watertown, and hopefully Governor Deval Patrick, Boston Mayor Thomas Menino, and we assume Colonel Alden from the Massachusetts State Police. They were supposed to have a briefing earlier today around 2 o'clock. That has now been postponed to what we think is 5:30 as they continue this massive manhunt and really Metro Boston on a night which really is in the midst of a major commute right now this time of the week in a massive manhunt for 19-year-old Zokhar Zanyev. The 19-year-old ID'd as suspect number 2, the man in the white hat from the surveillance images. Now, we're in Watertown at the mall. This is a command center, and it is heavily armed with police, both local police, state police surrounding the area, tactical teams, SWAT teams, Humvees, military helicopters, bomb squad units, and the National Guard as well. Arsenal Street has been shut down to the public and businesses in this area. There has been a shelter in place in Metro Boston all day long. Mass transit has been shut down. There was no way to go in or out of Watertown this afternoon. They're still asking residents to remain inside. Do not open the door unless you know it's a uniformed police officer with proper ID. And even though their focus right now is here in Watertown, Governor Deval Patrick is heeding that advice, hopefully.
The stay-indoor request continues for the time being. That is unchanged. There are continuing developments in the investigation, which we will be able to talk about, not now, but later. But it is important that folks remain indoors and not open the door, keep the doors locked and not open the door unless there is a uniformed, identified law enforcement officer on the other side of it requesting to come inside.
We'll have more on that shelter in place from News 8's Ally Miles in just a second, but also another footnote here, a local tie here, is a Maine State Police detective has indeed been in Boston since Tuesday, lending assistance to the FBI and authorities here. State Police spokesman Steve McCausland says the detective has a specific area of expertise that investigators need. So, we're waiting for a possible 5:30 press conference from the Colonel of the Massachusetts State Police, Timothy Alden, and we assume Governor Deval Patrick. Live here in Watertown, Massachusetts, Norm Karkos, News 8.
So, Norm, you mentioned that Maine State Police officer, a lot of hands on deck, very heavy police presence. You can see the long guns out there. You've been out there for so many hours. Have you seen the situation evolve, change, go back to the way it was? How has it developed?
Well, a couple of hours ago when we actually first arrived about 3 blocks down, an area was really isolated by police. There was some media presence there. They were asked to leave because they thought they saw someone who at time was suspicious. But Massachusetts State Police told us at the time that was no one of interest right there, and they cleared that area. A little bit of a lull right now. We're just seeing motorcycles, a motorcade of police and helicopters flying over. That's been kind of protocol all afternoon long. Police coming in. They've been dog sniffing bombs in this area. So that's really been protocol here for the last 5 hours since we've been here, Megan.